This week's scouting segment is going to be a little bit different than what we usually hear as the norm. And we're going to talk about high impact hunting on a property versus low impact hunting. And by that I mean we spent years reading and buying into the theories about having as little impact on that property that you're hunting as possible, keeping your scent to the minimum all year long until hunting season, then going in and trying to shoot that deer. And what we've found in recent years is that when hunting season comes, we increase our activity on that property, and that increases the amount of alert deer on that property, because now we're on that property more, they're hearing trucks, they're hearing people, they're coming across where we've walked to and from a stand. And when hunting season comes and your activity on that property increases, it can kind of be a shock to the deer because they're not used to it. And now they're coming across where you've walked, they're hearing vehicles, they're seeing you walk across fields. And it's not something they're conditioned to. So what we've actually started to do in recent years is to increase our presence on a property even above what we need to. So when we go to check trail cameras, we don't worry about shutting the door too loud. We don't worry about the kids making noise when they get out of the truck. We take the dog and we let the dog go for a run while we're setting up a stand. And the reason we do that is because that activity on the property all throughout the year, what it does is it conditions a deer to understand that there's a certain level of human presence on that property that's not a threat. And that's your Canadian Whitetail Scouting segment for the week.